Hello YouTube, this is GamingBrosA&J here. I'm gonna bring you guys my updated Marcus Davis deck. Last time I did a deck profile, you guys liked this deck, so yeah. Before I get on with it, I'd like you guys to subscribe or like. I'll be posting mostly Yu-Gi-Oh on this channel if you guys haven't noticed. I would like to have more subscribers, have people watch. I'm going to try to get as much uploading I can do. Right now I'm just in the basics. I got to get a lot of camera. I'm only using my phone right now. So I would like to subscribe for more Yu-Gi-Oh content. Okay. I'll be having another opening video up here soon. So I'm going to get started with my deck here. So everyone, Drake area, the basic Drake cards you really need in this deck. Around three soprano, you know, helps contact fusion. You know, you don't need conversation for this, so it helped a lot. Summon it out. I use around three cannon. People like to run one or two, I like to run three due to its special summon effect for exceed plays, and that's pretty much it. Or once per turn, you can target one with Steve, a bunch of control, and change the battle position, but that's not really that good. But and then for and text, play one Elegy and one Sonata just for tech boost and all that. Do play one solo just for her special summon effect, and when she's destroyed by battle, you can special summon one monster, helps get area out, just get her effect, so it'll be helpful. I play two Mozarts and one Sylphina. The reason why I run two Mozarts and one Sylphina is that I like to special summon from the hand more than from the graveyard. And it's more non-cloggy that way. It gets you up. Sometimes this deck can really get your hand cloggy and you can't really do a lot of stuff. So I use Mozarts a bit more. And that's it for the Melodious monsters. Go for the monsters here. We got two Honest. You can run two score in this deck, but right now I only use two Honest. Two Summoner Monks and Colony Bird for some more special summoning support for area. You need these special summoning effect. It's mainly to get area out and play off of her effect. But you can't do anything really. So, I went through the spells. You know, you gotta have three first movement solos. So, you need three of these, of course. I want two MSTs. I'd rather have MSTs in this deck instead of Mystical Typhoon. Ah, oh, that's what I just said. That's 22 Twisters, never mind. You want MST in here besides Twin Twisters, because you don't really want to discard any cards right then and there. Because you need those multiple cards for your plays. So that's why I want MSTs. And if I put a third MST, it's going to get cloggy. So, that's the same with polymerization here. Having more than two gets cloggy. So, and I use Fusion Sage for support to search it out. And I've been always want to test this card out in this deck. Fusion Gate. It's very good. So, for special summoning other cards, I use Castell, Transformation, Valhalla, and Soul Charge. Really good special summon, but I wish I can get another Castell transformation instead of Valhalla. It's because it's once per turn and you have to control no monsters, I think. Yes. That's right. And then for the last plus, one Rageki and one of Star Goblin. One for the traps. sorry. I run two Mirror Force. The reason I want Mirror Force in here is just that the other person, your opponent can get a big field on this deck because you don't really destroy a lot of cards on the field right then and there, so it really helps just destroy the monsters because like a lot of these strikes doesn't even get out, take off monsters, just helps you you know, you should know about this deck, it's been out for a long time, so I'm not going to explain that much. I can do play one Soul Morning and one Soul Strike. It's not, I really don't think it's a need just to run three solemn strikes and one solemn warning in this deck. These two are just fine. I'm not a big, huge life point, gambler, just to waste these. But yeah, one strike and one warning be good in this deck. And then you need two Call of the Haunted, just to push someone out your areas from the graveyard. And then stop a lot of good plays. You need area, for some area out in that Infinity's Fiend on your field. That's for the main deck. For the extra deck here, the main extra deck card, just hit the game up with two Boom Divas. Really need to get this card out. It has a lot of plays too. Or, you know, you can't actually. It's hard to get rid of this card actually. It cannot be destroyed with battle or back artifacts. So. You got like use, let's see, Silent Monarch or Castell. Then I run Creature Birda. I don't want to try out this Bloom Prima in this deck. I would take this out if it doesn't do so well for another Bloom Diva. So there's the Fusions, Rixies. I like to run two 101s, two Castells, one 106, one Time Tower Wolf, one Xe Dragon, Castell Emerald, and Cowboy for a game. Every time someone faces me with a Cowboy, they always try to do it for a game. So. And then for the side deck, I got a side deck for this time. I was going to say something, but it's not needed. Play three effect failures. Due to, I want to run effect failures more in this deck, is due to it's a light card. Like, I want to keep this pure light deck mainly, and it's not really good, but are better than Ghost Ogre and Snow Rab or Winter Cherries and all that. But it's very helpful in this deck. And it's a tuner. I would like to have a Synchro in this deck, but I don't have room, so. I do play two some more scores in here. I can change that out for the Honest, or you can just put them in there if the other opponent has a bigger field. I have a big monsters and all that, so it's very helpful to have two more scores in extra besides the Honest. I do play one Ghost Ogre and Snow Rabbit. Just, you know, I only have one of them. And same with Mexi, just for Char Power, because I only have one of them. You can have boost these two up. But, yeah. I play two Comungus Sticky Stream Kaiju. The reason why I play two of him instead of the 22 beater one is that you don't want to go too strong or too weak. You want to get it just right. Say if you have Bloom Demon out on the board, you should press some of this on your opponent's 5 field. You can attack your Bloom Team on this, and they take 1400 damage instead of 1200. So, and your opponent in this Bloom Team doesn't get destroyed. So, I play two spell Shattered Arrow. I do not like anti spell trap card because I think it's just too strong. You know, at least you just need to destroy the scales on them. So that's why I run two of these. Just destroy the scales and you have like 1000 damage. Probably do it for game sometimes too. So, I'll put one Inflatia and Boundless and Trap Tricks Trap Hole. You can switch these out for Mirror Force or, just pretty much Mirror Force. You really want to keep the Solemns in there. So, and you can put Inflatia in there and do that instead. So, then last but not least, another Bloom Diva. Gotta have three Bloom Divas. This is good. Summon this card out. So, that'll be it for my deck. Hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys can subscribe for more content. I hope my channel can enhance later on. But I just need support from you guys, whoever watch. So, please subscribe. Post another video in at least two more days. So, yeah, it's GameBrosA&J.